My name is Komla Atite, an employee of NIH working as a fellow in biostatistical and computational biology branch. My mentor is Benedict Achand, a Stardman investigator in the NIH division of National Institute of Environmental Health Science. Today, I will talk about the benchmarking framework for optimal visualization and the interpretability of high-dimensional separable data. Visualization is an important tool for generating meaning from scientific data, but the visualization of structures in high-dimensional data presents a challenge. Dimension reductions methods are key in solving this challenge, but this method can be misleading, especially when apparent clustering in the dimension reducing representation is used as the basis for reasoning about the relationships within the data. Through the review of 24 of dimensionality reduction methods, we selected the most common use of them to evaluate the computational framework presented in this work. We developed five metrics with five different features to measure the performance of the dimensionality reduction method for good visualizations. The first, denoted as a separability index, evaluated how far apart the clusters of the same data are to each other. It also assesses the outlier of clusters in terms of the neighborhood size. The second metric called gradient boosting classifier index evaluates the balance of bias and variance in the reduced data in terms of the number of trees. It also assesses how well the structure of the original data is preserved. The third metric, named as occupation index, assesses how close the coverage of the low dimensional space is to the coverage of the original space. The fourth metric, Turtle Uniformity Index, measures the uniform spread of data in the low dimensional space in terms of the grid size. The fifth metric, named the Time Order Searching Index, gauges how the data in the low dimensional space is correlated to different times at which the original data were collected. We aim to determine the information which governs the communications of the parameter with the metrics. We then use three different single-cell data sets of different biological processes such as epithelium to mesenchymal transition, EMT, the induced pluripotent stem cell, iPSC, and the spermatogenesis. For all the C methods, the separability index presents the optimal neighborhood size in the range varying from 3 to 8. The gradient boosting classifier index evaluated the optimal number of trees in the range varying from 50 to 100. The occupation index provides the optimal grid number giving the best coverage of the projected data varying in the range 5 to 20. Provided by the C method, the uniformity index showed that points seem to be more spread out in the low dimensional space with low spread size. So the time order structure index revealed that all the C methods retain time dependency in the structure of the projected data just for a few time steps of 1 to 20 over 250 time steps. In the correlation analysis, we use Pearson and Spearman coefficient to measure the statistical relationship between the feature of metrics describing the accuracy of the method. The computational framework is based on the conditions that if there is a correlation between the feature of metrics for good visualization and interpretability, then the evaluations of the method should take account of that correlation in the Bayesian multilevel modeling. In the case there is no relationship between the feature of the metrics, the evaluations of the method could be limited on just using independently the metrics. The task of the Bayesian multi-level modeling is to explain the relationship between multiple independent or predictor variables, which are the feature of the matrix, and the one criterion variable, which is the accuracy of a method. It leads to model the conditional effect of the matrix on the performance of method design for the reductions of high-dimensional data. Based on the Markov chain Monte Carlo sample of the posterior distributions of the ascertained parameter assigned to the feature of the matrix, we use the high density interval to summarize the credible interval of the posterior distributions of each of them. We rank the method in terms of the optimizations for good visualizations and interpretability of a given biological process as follows. If the goal of classification is to evaluate the budgeted data in terms of presenting few outliers from dense clusters, then FIT, autoencoder, and PCA are the best method. In case the classifier require preserving the structure of the original data after projections, then FIT and the SEVS are the greatest method. If good classification refers to a good coverage of the low dimensional space, then autoencoder is the finest method. For visual uniform spread of classes in the projected space, TCNE, UMAP, and PCA are the preeminent method. And defining classification in terms of time dependency of the projected data structure, FIT represented the foremost method. None of the C methods highlighted above was optimal simultaneously for all the five objectives. We then introduced a neural network approach called the variational autoencoder, which provides a probabilistic manner for describing an observation in latent space. In conclusion, we propose an optimal variational autoencoder as a method that preserves meaningful property of the original biological process after reductions, as well as provide better visualizations and interpretability. We conclude that this work investigated the performance of a chosen dimensionality reduction method as a function of a good classification, visualizations, and interpretability. This work is funded by NIH Divisions of Intramural Research. Thank you.